To replace the axle ring, you will require the axle ring replacement kit, article number 8572, a TX20 wrench, a 17mm wrench, a 10mm wrench, a 15mm wrench, and some grease. The axle plate is attached to the axle ring with either 5 axle plate screws using a quick change axle ring, pictured left, or 6 axle plate screws pre-2003, pictured right. To replace the axle ring, we first need to remove the old one by removing these screws. The quick change axle ring has an extra screw under the axle plate which must also be removed. Do not flip the wheel over once the screws and components have been removed. Oil can drain out of the open holes. The small freewheel springs in the axle ring side can also easily be misplaced. Remove the old paper gaskets. Now synchronize the speed hub by using the 8mm socket to shift the speed hub into gear 8. Rotate the hexagonal peg anticlockwise to the bed stop and then count 6 clicks clockwise to locate gear 8. Before fitting the new axle ring, check that both new paper gaskets are sitting correctly so that all axle ring holes are visible. If the freewheel springs were dislodged when removing the old axle ring, make sure they are now sitting correctly. Ensure both hub cable ends are the same length. In this position, the groove of the cable pulley should direct towards the 9 to 10 o'clock position. Please note, the stainless steel axle ring screw is shorter than the axle plate screws. Check the smooth function of the new hub cable by pulling each cable end alternately through all 13 indexed clicks. In each end position, the cable length should be the same. Smear with grease before remounting the axle plate in the original position. Tighten the axle plate screws to 3 Newton meters in a cross formation to ensure even torque. Check again that the replaced gear mech runs smoothly throughout all 13 indexed clicks. Mount the wheel back into the frame, ensuring the axle plate is correctly seated. Close the quick release skewer or tighten the axle nuts to secure it in place. The task is finished by connecting the male and female bayonet connectors. Be sure to hold the bayonet over the screw heads to avoid the need for excessive force. If needs be, the cable tension can be tweaked using the 2 barrel adjusters. Correct cable tension should leave approximately 2 to 3 mm of play in the twist shifter. This ensures the indexing is clearly defined whilst shifting. For further information, visit us online at www.rohloff.de or refer to your local bike shop. We thank you for your interest.